Okay, so we will start with the first one, which is dividend discount model. So how do you calculate value from dividend discount model? You forecast future dividend and then you calculate it, the present value of all the dividends, and that will give you the value of the company. So let's say there is a company which pays dividend every year, and you expect that it will continue to pay dividend every year, and you, and whatever it generates is paid as dividend. So you think that dividend is the right metric to calculate its value. So it paid a dividend in first year, let's say $5. It paid a dividend in second year, let's say for example $5.5. then it paid $6, and then it paid $6.5, and then so on. You expect it to continue to pay dividends forever. Now you are calculating value. So simply, how will you calculate value? That you will calculate the present value of this 5, then you will calculate the present value of 5.5, then present value of 6, then present value of 6.5, and you should add them up, and when you add them up, that becomes a value. Is there anything which is missing from here, or is there any change which I need to make? The problem here is that we have only forecasted 4 years of dividend and we have calculated its present value. 4 years is not enough. Why? We need to calculate, or we need to estimate all the future dividends and then take their present value. Just taking the present value of 4 years is not enough. So how do you then get the value? You get the value by estimating all the future dividends. So now the question is that if I am estimating all the future dividends, then it will, it might be 100 cash flows, 200 cash flows, 1000 cash flows, and it wouldn't be practical, or it wouldn't be humanly possible to actually forecast all the future cash flows. So what we do is that we forecast it for a reasonable period, let's say 5 to 10 years, and then we assume a cash flow at the end of the year. So for example, agar maine 5 saal ke liye forecast kar liya, so this is my 7 years of, this is my 5 years of forecast. And then I can assume that at the end of 5 year, asset will be sold for example, let's say $50. So that means ke 5 saal mein ye dividends milenge, or at the end of 5th year, it can be sold for $50. And when you sell it for $50, then this $50 captures all the remaining dividends or all the remaining benefit from that asset. So what you can do is that whenever you are calculating value at some point in time, that is at after a some point in time, if you think that asset will continue to go in future or will continue to give benefit in future, then at the end of 1 year, last year, what you can do is you can estimate what will be the price of asset at this point of time. Either you can estimate this that what is the price at which you will be able to sell it, because when you sell it, you will get some cash flow. Or you can estimate a terminal value, that what will be the terminal value of this asset at the end of this year. And terminal value means the remaining cash flows, that what will be the remaining cash, what will be the present value of all the remaining cash flows on the 5th year. So for example, if I find out that at the end of 5th year, the asset will be valued at, or at the end of 5th year, the terminal value of the asset or price of the asset will be $50. Now what I can do is I can sum up all these cash flows. It becomes 57, it becomes 6.5, 6, 5.5 and 5. And then I can calculate present value of all of these and present value of all of these, and then sum them up, and that will become the value. So then value will be the sum of all the present value of all the future cash flows. Any questions, confusion, claim? That is, you will forecast all the future dividends or all the future cash flows, and at the end of the last cash flow that you have forecasted, you will forecast a terminal value as well. Then you sum them up, and after summing them up, you calculate present value of all of these, and then you will sum them up, and that will give you your value. So value will be the present value of future cash flows. Quick question hai, or any clarity required? Okay, so do this question. You have been provided annual dividends for next 3 years, which are expected to be $2, $2.1 and $2.2. The expected price is expected to be $20 at the end of 3 years. That means first year mein $2 dividend, then second year mein 2.1, and then third year mein 2.2. And in third year, the estimated price in third year is $20. What is the estimated value of the share? So how will you do it? You will calculate present value of all the future, all these future cash flows, and then that sum them up, and that will be your value. So iski value calculate karein kitni aa rahi hai. Anyone having any issues with it? Okay, so now we'll move on. Gordon growth model. So we discussed, so again, taking the same example from the previous question. Let's say that you again have dividends of $2, 2.2. And 2.4, and at the end of this third year, you don't know what the price will be. So what you need to do then is that you need to find out the terminal value. What is the terminal value? Terminal value is the present value of all the remaining cash flows. Now, in order to calculate terminal value, one of the ways that you can do it is that you can use a model known as Gordon growth model. What is a Gordon growth model? Gordon growth model assumes a constant growth rate. So Gordon growth model tells you that what will be the present value of all the future cash flows if this cash flow continues to grow at a constant growth rate. So the key assumption of Gordon growth model is that from this point onward, it will continue to grow at a constant growth rate. So a Gordon growth model can tell you that what will be the present value of all the remaining cash flows, or what will be the terminal value here if this dividend continues to grow at a constant growth rate. So from this point of time, if you think that dividend will continue to grow at a constant growth rate, what you can do is you can use Gordon growth model to calculate the terminal value. So Gordon growth model is very simple. That is current year dividend multiplied by 1 plus G divided by R minus G. This R is your required rate of return, and this G is your sustainable growth rate. Also, so G is your sustainable growth rate, also known as SGR. So what you are actually doing is that you are taking current year dividend, and when you take current year dividend, and when you multiply this current year dividend with 1 plus growth rate, it will give you next year's dividend, which is D1, and divided by R minus G. So either you can take current year multiplied by 1 plus G divided by R minus G, or you can take next year dividend divided by R minus G, because current year multiplied by 1 plus G is next year's dividend. So if I am standing here at year 3, and if I am estimating the terminal value at year 3, what will I do? My current year is year 3. So I will take 2.4. multiplied it by 1 plus G and divided by R minus G. So let's say, for example, R is a discount rate is 10%. So then it will be 2.4 multiplied by 1 plus G divided by 10% minus G. Now the question is that what is this G? What is this sustainable growth rate? So theoretically, the sustainable growth rate is calculated. Theoretically, sustainable growth rate is calculated with the formula retention ratio multiplied by ROE, return on equity multiplied by retention ratio or retention rate. What is retention ratio? Retention ratio is 1 minus payout ratio. And what is payout ratio? So for example, let's say there is a company which earned $100, and from this $100, it paid out dividend of $80. So from the $100 earnings, the company paid out dividend of $80. Then it means its payout ratio is 80 divided by 100. So payout ratio is dividend divided by earnings. And whatever it has retained, that is the retention ratio. So for example, if it has paid out 80 out of 100, that means it has paid out 80%. If it has paid out 80%, then it has retained 1 minus 80%, which is 20%. So this 20% is retention rate. So sustainable growth rate is equal to retention rate multiplied by ROE. So when you multiply these two, you get sustainable growth rate. And how do you get retention rate? You get retention rate by doing 1 minus payout ratio. And what is payout ratio? Payout ratio is dividend divided by earnings. Through this, you can find out this G. And once you have G and R and current year dividend, you should be able to find out terminal value. So let's do an example for practice. So let's continue with the same question. So let's assume that this company has dividend of 2.4, and normally it has dividend of or let's say on average it has dividend of 2.2, and on average it has dividend of, for example, it has earnings of let's say,
sir,
3G. So you will, in this model, you will assume, you will forecast cash flows for that point of time from which onwards you can assume a constant growth rate. So if I think that after third year, the dividend growth rate will be constant, that is sustainable growth rate can be applied. I will take 3 years. I can take 3 years. If I think that from today onwards, dividend growth rate is constant, that is dividend growth rate will always be constant, then I can apply it today as well. If you think that after fifth year onward, it will have a constant growth rate, then we will apply it from fifth year. So it will depend when you assume the growth rate to be constant. So if I tell you that from today onwards, if let's say that all this is not given, none of this is given. And if I tell you that from today onwards, the dividend growth rate in future will remain be constant, then you can directly apply this model. You do not then need to forecast. Why? Because from today onward, it will remain be constant. So for example, if I tell you that current year dividend was 2, and from today onward, current year dividend was 2, and from next year onward, the growth will remain be same. So you will find out that dividend is, for example, 2, and earnings is, let's say, 4. So then your payout ratio is 2 divided by 4, which is 50%. If your payout ratio is 50%, your retention rate is 1 minus 50%, which is again 50%. Then you find out ROE. Let's say that the ROE is 15%. So if ROE is 15%, then your sustainable growth rate will be retention rate multiplied by ROE. 50% into 15%, which is 7.5%. And then I tell you that from next year onward, it will continue to grow at the SGR, at the sustainable growth rate, that is 7.5% first year and onward. So now you do not need to forecast any cash flows. Simply what you can do is you can calculate today's value. Why? Because you know that it will continue to grow at 7.5%. So let's say that your discount rate is 10%. So the value as of today will be 2 multiplied by 1 plus G. Your G is 7.5%, so 1.075 divided by R minus G. So R is 0.1 minus G is 0.075. And when you solve it, you will get the value. Kya answer aa raha hai iska? Okay. So 2 into 1.075 divided by 0.1. This means that if this dividend continues to grow forever at the constant growth, then the present value of that will be, or the value of that is $86. If there is another scenario in which I tell you that it will not continue to grow at the same rate, it will grow at, let's say, 10% next year. Then it will grow at 9%, for example, just taking a random number, 3.3. And then it will go on to, for example, 4.3. Then it will go on to, for example, 5.2. And after this fourth year, then it will continue to grow at sustainable growth rate. Then you need to forecast it for 4 years. And then after that, you will apply the same formula for terminal value at this year. And then you will discount back all the cash flows to present. So it depends on the assumption ke wo kab se constant ho jati hai growth rate. Just year onward constant ho jayegi, us year ke upar terminal value nikali ja sakti hai by using this formula. And if the assumption is ke agle saal se hi constant hai, तो फिर आज की वैल्यू भी निकाली जा सकती है यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला, देन यू डू नॉट नीड टू फोरकास्ट फ्यूचर कैश फ्लोज. सो इट विल डिपेंड कि आप किस ईयर ऑनवर्ड जो है वो अज्यूम कर रहे हैं कि ये ग्रोथ कॉन्स्टेंट हो जाएगी. बिकॉज दिस मॉडल, जब ये मॉडल वैल्यू कैलकुलेट करेगा तो इट विल अज्यूम के फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट ऑनवर्ड ग्रोथ विल रिमेन बी कॉन्स्टेंट. Okay, so then now you have a question. A stock paid a dividend of $2 per share this year and it is trading at $90 per share. Dividend is expected to grow at an annual rate of 10% over the next 3 years. From fourth year and onwards, retention rate is expected to be 50% and ROE is forecasted to be 10%. Required rate of return on equity is 8%. Calculate intrinsic value of a stock using Gordon growth model. So, ye calculate karein. So this year means year zero. On year zero, it paid a dividend of $2. And then dividend will grow at 10% over the next 10 years, over the next 3 years. So that means in first year, in second year, and in third year, dividend will grow at 10%. So if you know that it will grow at 10%, you can find out these numbers that what will be the dividend in first year, what will it be in second year, what will it be in third year. Then they have told you that from fourth year onwards, that is next year from third, retention rate is expected to be 50 and ROE is 10. So if you know retention rate, if you know ROE, you can find out sustainable growth rate, which is ROE into retention rate. And then if you know sustainable growth rate, if you also know the required rate of return on equity, then you should be able to find out the terminal value at the end of year three. And then you discount them back to present and that will be your value. A key point to note is that this dividend, which has already been paid, will not be a part of value. So this year zero dividend will not be added to calculate value. Value will depend on only the future cash flows. So only the future cash flows will be taken into valuation. Another key point to note is that isme hum jo forecast kar rahe hain cash flow, that forecasted cash flow is dividend. And dividend goes to equity holders. So as this is a cash flow to equity holders, this is discounted back using the required rate of return on equity. This will not be discounted back using WACC. So WACC isko dividend ko discount back karne ke liye use nahi hoga. क्योंकि वैक इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल टू द होल कंपनी. इट हैज एन एलिमेंट ऑफ डेट एज वेल एज एक्विटी. जबकि डिविडेंड जो है वो इज अ कैश फ्लो टू एक्विटी. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर डिस्काउंटिंग डिविडेंड, यू डू नॉट यूज वैक, यू विल यूज कॉस्ट ऑफ एक्विटी और रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न ऑन एक्विटी. सो ये पॉइंट याद रखिएगा, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. सो हमने करा क्या है कि ईयर जीरो में इट इज टू, year 1 mein when you increase it by 10% it will be 2.2, then again when you increase it by 10% it will be 2.4 something. ye two decimal places mein kuch aur hoga, one decimal tak round off hoga, isliye you are seeing it as 2.4. then third year mein when you increase it by 10% it will be 2.7. so 1.1 into 2 will be this number, then 2.2 into 1.1 will be this number, and then when you multiply this number by 1.1, then you will get this 2.7. so increasing 10% by every year. Then you need to calculate terminal value. So terminal value will be this final year cash flow, which is 2.7 multiplied by 1 plus g. g is your sustainable growth rate. So sustainable growth rate is the retention rate multiplied by ROE. So 0.5 multiplied by 0.1, which is 0.05. So 1 plus 0.05 current year dividend multiplied by 1 plus g divided by r minus g. So r is your required rate of return on equity. Remember, this is not ROE, this is required rate of return on equity. This is the discount rate, this is the cost of equity, not ROE. So r 0.08 minus sustainable growth rate, which is 0.05. so when you do this, you will get the terminal value, which comes out to be 93.2. So now you have these future cash flows, 2.2, 2.4, 2.7 and 93.2. Then you sum them all up and it will be 2.2, 2.4, 95.8. This will not be taken into valuation. Why? Because this has already happened. And when calculating value, we only take future cash flows which have not been received as of now. Then you calculate their present values. So this, these are the present values. Present value, what will you do? You will divide it by 1 plus R to the power T. So for 2.2, the T is 1. So 1 plus R to the power 1. Then for 2.4, 1 plus R to the power 2. And then for 95.8, 1 plus R to the power 3. So these are your present values. When you sum up the present values, you get this answer, which is 80.2. इसमें प्रॉब्लम है किसी को?